The Minister for ICT and National Guidance, Chris Baryomunsi, has made a call for the improvement of journalists' pay. He was officiating at the National Association of Broadcasters' annual general meeting in Kampala, where he recognized and decried poor pay of journalists in Uganda.
My remarks that I get from your employees is that they are poorly paid. And one of their concerns was, can you talk to our employers to give us something better?
He noted that several journalists struggled financially during COVID-19-induced lockdown because many are paid per story, yet several events were on hold. The information minister contends that poor pay of journalists has negative effects on their ethical conduct.
So I also want to appeal to you that despite the challenges that you face in raising resources and making the business thrive, but also consider the pride of our journalists.
Baryomunsi, who opened the 24th annual general meeting, also condemned the unending cases of brutality meted on journalists by security agencies and promised to summon a joint meeting when National Association of Broadcasters will interface with security chiefs to find a lasting solution to this problem.
So we tried to put down fires, say let's create harmony, play football, do this. But I think you need to go back to cabinet, talk to your colleagues, Minister of Defense, Minister of Internal Affairs, and say these are our partners, we need them, let's not harass them.
The way a medical doctor leaves his house to go to hospital to work on patients, the way a teacher leaves his home to go to a classroom or a lecture room to teach, the way I leave my home as a parliamentarian to go to parliament to legislate, or to go to the minister, the way a journalist leaves his home to go and work, and we are all serving our country. So no journalist should be beaten or harassed.
The outgoing chairperson of National Association of Broadcasters, Ken Karisa, lobbied the minister for incentives on signet charges, saying the levy makes the cost of doing media business too expensive to make business sense.
They listen, but sometimes when it comes to implementation, maybe messages do not go down to the right people. So we need to engage again. We believe signal distribution is still very expensive. Given the environment we operate in, people don't make money. There's no way they can make 10 million or even 5 million to pay for radios.
Media managers tasked the government to come out and give timelines on when it will regulate bloggers, vloggers and other related online news outlets which are outcompeting the mainstream media, yet they neither pay taxes nor are licensed. Karisa explained that these outlets are the main perpetrators of fake news, which is blamed on the mainstream media.
You've seen bloggers, you've seen people have set up channels, online channels, they wake up every day to abuse people, give out information, they attack whoever they wish to attack, but they advertise. You see this property is being advertised, so they're encroaching on your wallet. The same wallet you would have gotten as a radio or a TV to advertise, they encroach on the same. But they don't have a license.
Media owners adopted amendments in their constitution before proceeding to vote for new leadership. Innocent Nahabwe emerged the new chairperson of the association, deputized by Joe Chigozi. Joseph Weyanga and Moses Atenge of Vision Group retain their positions as Secretary General and Treasurer, respectively.
Of NAB, and there have been constitutional amendments with NAB. Now NAB has something we call an advisory board of trustees. We are glad to have our own CEO, Mr. Don Wanyama, who has also been nominated and elected a trustee to the board.
Ken Karisa was elected as the chairperson board of trustees of the National Association of Broadcasters, while the Vision Group CEO, Don Wanyama, was elected to sit on the board. Story compiled by Fred Kajubi for the news.